Now, this program today is part of an empowerment series which we've been running for quite a few years. We choose a theme each year, and then we partner with different seniors groups in the city to present different aspects of that theme. So this year, the theme is You and Your Money. And today, March is Fraud Awareness Month. I don't know if everybody knows that I'm standing in front of you, sorry.
It's all right.
But it's Fraud Awareness Month this month. So today we're going to be talking about financial frauds and scams. So this is the fourth in our series, and there's two more to come. And if you've picked up a program from outside, you'll see where the other two are. One's going to be on the North Shore, one's going to be at Temple Shalom. And those are in April and May. And there's some evaluation forms that are going to go around after. So I hope that everybody fills them out. We've also got refreshments happening afterwards. So I'm just going to ask Lorraine Isaacson to say a few words about Shalom Aleichem Seniors, and then Al Stein is the moderator and he'll start the program.
I just want to welcome everybody and want to just tell you a little bit about my programs, in as much that I put outside my March and April program, because we meet every Friday and we have stimulating programs, and I'd love to see you all come on a Friday morning. So that's my little plug, but I'm just going to hand now the floor over to Al, who is our moderator. Al, thank you.
I'm going to try and speak without a microphone as well. Again, good morning and welcome. It's good to see a good crowd out here. You know, it's really too bad that the month of March has to be declared Fraud Prevention and Awareness Month. But then again, we live in a free enterprise system, and I suppose there's nothing more free and enterprising than fraud. Unfortunately, these guys, these activities are not only immoral and illegal, but they actually hurt a lot of people. And that's what we're here to talk about. You know, hardly a week goes by that we don't hear about another major fraud that has been perpetrated. And it seems that the internet has only added to the variety of frauds and scams being attempted. Well, fortunately, there are organizations and authorities whose role it is to protect the public from this sort of abuse. And we are privileged to have with us today, and very fortunate, to have three presenters representing three different agencies actively involved in fraud prevention and public education. I will ask first for Jeff to speak. I will introduce them all and then ask Jeff to speak first. Jeff Bowser has been with the BC Securities Commission for almost 10 years. First as a software developer, then as a compliance officer, and more recently he has been seconded to the enforcement division as an investigator in the investigations branch. The next presenter will be Linda Pasacrita, who is with the Better Business Bureau and since 2007, when she became president and CEO of that organization. Linda, in addition to educating the public about fraud prevention strategies, has also given customer service seminars to both Better Business accredited businesses and non-accredited businesses, offering over 25 years of sales experience and insights in that area. Our third presenter will be Linda Grange here, who is with the Vancouver Police Department, has been a police officer for 9 years and in the Financial Crimes Unit for 2 years, where she says she's focused on telemarketing and mail fraud, computer fraud, such as Craigslist, and other scams involving frauds against the elderly, including the never-ending Nigerian money scam, and also romance scams, which I didn't realize exist, but apparently they do.
Of course, I am all with you.
Linda estimates that she has recovered or intercepted over $1 million in fraudulent funds.